Beacon Press Audio presents Loving Our Own Bones, Disability Wisdom and the Spiritual Subversiveness of Knowing Ourselves Whole by Julia Watts Belser. This audiobook is narrated by Sara Sheckells, published by Beacon Press Audio, 2023. Chapter 1. Claiming Disability. After synagogue one day, a visitor popped the question. "What's wrong with you?" she asked, as her eyes flicked from my face to my wheels. I've been asked this question in an astounding array of inappropriate venues. I didn't flinch. "I have a disability," I said, though it was plain she'd already noticed. A firm stop follows that statement, though I know full well I didn't answer her question. I'm more than willing to talk about disability, but I'm disinclined to do so while waiting in the buffet line for my salad. In truth, my answer is something of a lie. What's wrong with me has more to do with exclusion, objectification, pity, and disdain than with honest muscle and bone. Most folks I meet assume my disability is a medical story, that the place to start when we talk about disability is diagnosis. I take a different approach. A medical frame centers on bodies or minds that fail to measure up to certain expectations, focusing on symptoms, treatment, rehabilitation. I want to tell you a different kind of story. A story about social attitudes, architectural barriers, and cultural notions of normalcy that value certain modes of being over others. I want to tell you a story about power, about the thousand ways our cultures mark certain bodies and minds as normal, while designating others as deviant and defective. It's a story about the way certain bodies and minds get shut out of public space, about the way we get discarded, shunted into care homes, or locked up in prisons. It's a story about the endless hours I've spent hunting wheelchair-accessible apartments, about the times strangers on the street have cut in on private conversations to tell me that they'll pray for me. It's a story about ableism, about the deep, entrenched structures of our society that presume it's good and right and natural to live without a disability. It's a story about violence, about harm that cuts against body, spirit, and bone. It's also a story about joy. I was in college when I first experienced disability community, when I forged my first disability kinships. Though I'd been disabled all my life, I had just experienced a sudden, significant disability change. I started using an electric mobility scooter, and soon after, I got my first wheelchair. I took my first disability studies class, where I led a collective mapping project that documented and analyzed inaccessibility on campus, an experience that finally gave me language to name and make tangible the structures of exclusion that have shaped my life. I fell into friendships with activists and artists, with political crips, disabled dissidents and dreamers. I learned to dance, shedding the awkwardness I'd always felt on feet in favor of the whirl of wheels. Somewhere along the way, I claimed an uncanny kind of freedom, a recognition that my life, my body, my wheels were so far beyond the confines of the conventional that there was simply no point trying to press my bones into that facade. Disability movements have brought together many who live brilliantly unconventional lives for activism, artistry, and passionate community. In these circles, disability isn't a medical diagnosis, but a cultural movement. Approaching disability through the lens of culture allows us to recognize disability as a dimension of human diversity. This perspective has often been overlooked in religious circles. Religious communities have more often tended to treat disability as a problem to be solved than a perspective to be embraced. But I follow the lead of feminist, queer, womanist, and liberationist interpreters who have raised up the value of reading sacred texts through the prism of our own particularity. Reading the Bible through the lens of disability experience can transform the way we think about text and theology. Disability cracks open powerful new perspectives on spirit. Before we go further, let me say a few words about how I use the term disability. I claim disability as a vital part of my own identity, as a meaningful way of naming and celebrating the intricate unfolding of my own skin and soul. Such a choice is surely a minority position in this world. Living in a profoundly ableist culture, in a world where disability still serves as a seemingly natural marker of inferiority, claiming disability as a significant dimension of self remains profoundly countercultural. We're often taught to look past disability, to not bring it up in polite conversation. But I reject both of those approaches. I want you to see my disability. Disability is an ordinary fact of life and an essential part of my being. Like most identities, it's a mixed bag, sometimes painful, sometimes frustrating, sometimes flush with exquisite, unexpected joy. If you want to know me, you've got to know my disability. It's a core part of who I am, how I experience the world. I was born with cerebral palsy, and when I walked as a child, my heel used to strike the ground in its own distinctive rhythm. My gait was subject to scrutiny and no small disapproval. Everyone wanted to fix it. I was a very compliant child. I tried to walk right. I stretched the thick anchor of my heel cord. I practiced over and over the motion of heel before toe. But as I did my exercises night after night, I also remember this. I remember listening to the offbeat of my limp and loving the sound of my own step. The way my foot struck ground, the distinctive rhythm of my walk, they were my signature, something that was purely my own. This was the first spiritual insight I traced to disability experience, this decision to cherish something about myself that other people didn't value. Maybe you know this insight too. Maybe you know what it's like to say yes to yourself, even in the face of disapproval or disdain. As a kid who couldn't walk right, now as a woman who rolls through the world, as someone whose heart never learned to conform, I trace my own truest sense of self to the decision to embrace those quirky qualities of soul that some folks wish to eradicate, to do everything I could to make sure they survived. Growing up disabled, growing up queer, the stakes were stark. It was either kindle tenacious love for myself or swallow the world's projections whole. And so, I chose. I taught myself to trace the lines on the palms of my own hands, a contour of the sacred. I found and felt and claimed the holiness of my own bones. I said yes to my own heart, to my own soul. I had the brilliant audacity to call it good and know it whole. This book unfolds at the intersection of several worlds. I am scholar of disability in Jewish and Christian traditions, with a specialty in classical Jewish texts. I am a rabbi and spiritual teacher, passionate about bringing queer, feminist, and disability culture into conversation with sacred scriptures. And I am a disability activist, committed to building a world where disabled people thrive. For more than a decade now, I've been speaking and teaching about the intersection of disability, the sacred, and Jewish texts, in synagogues and churches, in college lecture halls and community centers, in theater arts circles and dance studios. In all of those contexts, one of the most common questions I hear is this.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.